Dr. Chalam is the principal of Sri Chaitanya College of Engineering, and he's a great visionary. He's integrated this program. He's included this program for almost all his students in the college, over 500 students. So let us hear from him about how he's overcome the challenges that we are all thinking about. And he's also has almost 14 years of experience from the industry. So he sees the value add of this program for his students.
Thank you, Lakshmi. Good morning to the director, Enhance Edu, and the team members of the Enhance Edu team, and all the principals coming over for this program. I would like to first thank Madam for giving us an opportunity for entering into an MOU with Enhance Edu. We are all very delighted, and we would like to thank first of all for giving us an opportunity. It was started in 2008 in the college when we went to a meeting in JNT University for a principal's meeting. There Madam was actually distributing pamphlets of Enhance Edu. I just got some pamphlet and I was just going through it, and later there was a principal's meeting at IIIT Hyderabad. So we have understood concept about it, and initially to start with we have deployed 4 faculties into this program. To start with the program, we have started with 4 faculty. Out of the 4 faculty, 2 faculty have dropped after I think 3 or 4 weeks, but other 2 faculty have completed their program of 8 weeks. So they came back into the college and they wanted to implement it, but we have a lot of constraints in inculcating this program into the academic curricula. I was just joined in that college in that year and trying to understand the college structure, the academic structure of it, and how to introduce this program into that. So a year has passed, but I was not able to do that. My vision was to see that at least 60 to 120 students of CSEIT department would be trained on this program. So the number of mentor student ratio was 1:10. The number of mentors were only 2. So it was not possible at that year. In the meantime, these 2 faculties who have been trained, they have got an opportunity in MNC companies. One has been placed in TCS and another is has been placed in Microsoft. Then it has really, it was really inquisitive, like our thought provoking, that when the program can make an average faculty enter into an MNC company like Microsoft or IBM or TCS, then it's really worth of that. I need to really focus on it. Then I started thinking that how can I do this now? Near about 10 faculty we have recruited exclusively for this. I wanted to ensure that I do this program at any cost. So we have trained, we have sent the faculty to IIIT in 2009, and again they went to this course and other things. In 2009 again there was a lot of disturbance. 2010 the program has been started, initiated, but we were not able to successfully complete the course because again structurizing this thing into the academic calendar is a big challenge. 80 hours is a big challenge, isn't it? As sir is also saying, that it's a very big challenge. Definitely it's a big challenge. So what we thought of is to increase the number of hours for the students. The college will be starting generally between 10 to 4. So we thought that why don't we increase the hours from 9 to 5. So 2 hours we have added in the regular curriculum. And we have tried to manage the academic calendar as per the university norms. And we have tried to include this curriculum into the second year students. So almost 10 mentors were there. So they have been started this program, and there were some difficulties in terms of arrangement of laboratories, arrangement of infrastructure and other things. So we were trying to balance it. the again in the next summer we have sent another 10 faculties. Again, out of these 10 faculty, another 5 people have got placed in IBM, Honeywell, XYZ, lot of MNC companies. Again, I need to recruit some more 10 people. I don't want to go back in this program. So I have taken another 10 people and sent these people for training. Near about 27 faculty have been trained from my group of institutions. And near about 273 students are being into this program now. From all the circuit branches, like EEEC, CSE and IT. One of the interesting things that I have found from the changes, like the changes that has been observed, is students are trying to understand things. They are able to learn things better. The statistics, I have statistical information, I can do the presentation also. In 2009-21 batch, second year first semester results, the result was 51%. Whereas the same 2010 batch, 2-1, the result was 62%. Specifically for the circuit branches who are having this training program of CIT. So what does it mean? The student's learning capability has been increased. Every second year student who are going this program seriously, the pass percentage was been increased far better. The number of class hours are as usual. The faculty are same. The subjects are same. Only thing what we have added is this specific program called CIT, the STEP program for students. And this has made a change. There was an increase of 12% in second year first semester result. The students have not yet completed the phases like Surikiran was explaining the different phases, phase 1, phase 2, phase 3. Out of that, the students have not yet completed phase 1 also. In spite of it, the result was reflecting to that extent. The percentages of each and every student, apart from the pass percentage, each and every student marks percentage have increased by 22%. These are the statistics figure I have with me. I just wanted to share this information for you. We do have a lot of challenges. I was able to convince from the management and the kind of management we have. We are very fortunate to have such a management. They have taken initiation and they have established a lab worth 30 lakhs exclusively for CIT program. And near about 10 slots are continuously running for this program because each lab can accommodate 12 slots. So we have now 10 slots completely occupied by CIT program. And this program, I believe that there would be a lot of change because the approach, whatever we have in this program, the learning by doing. Very simple example, sometime we had been sharing. We don't learn cycle by, don't ride the cycle or drive the cycle by studying a textbook, isn't it? We always try to practice it, then obviously we don't forget it. The same thing is happening here. And the faculty now has a lot of change. Now we have interested them for call amendments, development of call amendment software. They are ready to work on it and they are working on it. They have created some applications on it. And we are trying to create an ERP-based software based on their working up this program through CIT. Any application whatever is required for me, an attendance management or anything for timetable management or something like that, the faculty are themselves now getting involved and they are creating an application in hardly a week's time or 15 days time, they are able to create it. They themselves accept that there is a lot of change in the way they work. The way they understand the subject now. They have the confidence levels of each and every faculty has improved who have been involved in this program. I believe that this program can do miracles provided you have the determination to execute it with all the challenges that are going to be posed to you. It's only, I don't see that they are not supposed to, in fact, give advertisement or meeting and other things. It is our responsibility to see that our students get more employability skills, or they have more learning capabilities improved. So it is our duty to improve our students' learnability and employability. I believe that by the end of the second year batch, whatever is continuing, by the end of their course, like the BTEC course itself, when they enter into final year, they would be far better employable than any other student who had been passed in my college itself. I am sure about it. And I feel the change in students in the faculty. I believe that if we can determine to do it, then we can definitely do it. Any questions that you have related to implementation of this, you can ask me, then I will be able to, I think, address some of the questions, how we are able to solve the challenges. Accepted. But whatever faculty we are going to recruit, so for example, initially, I have convinced my management that these students, specifically we have taken only BTEC students, not an MTEC people. People who have completed their BTEC with 2 or 3 years experience, or maybe fresh graduates, or whatever case it may be. We have recruited them, and we said that we will be having this faculty specifically trained for the CIT program, and they also be completing their MTEC course in the college. We have an MTEC program in the college, and they will also be completing their MTEC course. It will, so they are more loyal to the college, because we are offering a PG program for them as part of the development of the faculty. And whatever they are learning here, they are trying to implement it. The workload is also been shared, the academic workload. So for example, here we are giving only 6 hours workload for each and every faculty as part of CIT, and the regular workload, whatever we are giving, is another 6 hours. The lab load is obviously there. See, the program is meant for second year students. As of now, the second year students have been going through that program now. This program, the first batch of the program is going on with 273 students enrolled on it.
You said how many faculty or members have been trained?
27 faculties have been trained as of now in the group of the institutions. We have near about 6 colleges. But my exclusive college, I am working as a principal for Sri Chaitanya College of Engineering. In my own exclusive college, 17 people have been trained on this. Out of them, now only 14 people are there, 3 have been left. From other group institutions, another 6 faculty have left. As of now, we have 21 mentors in the college, in the group college. We have a CSE of 120 and IT of 60. Yeah. Now, the main objective for me was to have every student enrolled. Why should any person be denied of getting a learning opportunity? Now, I think enhanced edu people has to decide on it. But as of now, like we had that constraint, and we have requested madam to enhance it to up to 1:15. They have accepted it, and we are going on fine as of now. 1:2, there are some people with 1:12 ratio, and some people with 1:15 ratio. Some mentors with 1:12, and some mentors with 1:15. Both the mentors are performing in the same pace. Both the mentors are performing in the same pace.
Case by case basis, only individual, we will say all bets are off. Just go away home. Meeting's over, right? So this is what we want people to understand, is that there has been some background and experience in this whole thing. And in this process, we have actually, this learning by doing in this whole mentoring approach has been tried out in our MSIT program, which is a master's in IT program. Many of whom, who you see in my team today, and I see your team, are graduates from MSIT who have learned by doing. So this has been the model. Now, after they have reached mastery, after they're able to do something more, then we can expand the team, but not on day one.
See, always be on safe side, because out of...
If you have 60 students, we will train 6 of your mentors for free this summer, so get them in there before the slot that they have.
It is always to be on safe side to have at least 8 mentors trained, because definitely there is a chance of that you will be losing your mentors for industry. But that proves that this program is more effective. See, when people are leaving for good MNC jobs like Microsoft or IBM, what does it mean? It means that a person who is not able to get a software job during his after completion of his BTech or MTech, whatever case it may be, now he is able to do it. He is able to get a job of top MNC company, top most MNC company. See, the our management does not constraint in the development of any of the faculty members, whether it is a student or a faculty.
I'm not talking about the management, I'm talking about the government of India.
Okay. I can address that. The NDDO is we want more students to be employable. Went back to college or went to the industry
unemployment is also important. After 3 years, you should not become an unemployed again. Okay, just because the Java part is over, another document has on the C has. So it should be a product-based company, and it should be a native industry. There are 10,000 electronics industries which are flourishing at Hyderabad, and the students are not aware of even 10% of those companies also. They are struggling for the good manpower. I mean, this kind of policy training programs should be focused on the native industry. So most of the trainers should be absorbed into, if somebody is absorbed in a small company, maybe, okay, it doesn't matter. Okay. I have seen companies with 5 to 10, also they are able to produce the product which is sellable at the product. It doesn't matter. So, when you meet next time, probably, you should make it a point.
We are also being part of this. Back. One more interesting fact is apart from the challenges, the senior faculties who are with 7 years, 8 years experience are now trying to compete with the people who have been trained in CIT. The faculties are now, they wanted themselves to be enrolled into CIT and they wanted that training to be done because they have, each mentor has a lot of followers, student followers now. Because everybody, every mentor is taking care of their students and they are getting better results. In spite of having been in academics for 6 to 7 years or 8 years, still they were not on par with the people who have been just trained for 8 weeks. That is one more interesting fact that I have been observed, and there are almost six faculty who have been with 6+ years associate professor, cadre level faculty are also been now interested and they have been participated in this program. And they are trying to compete with these faculties with less experience because they are seeing the difference in the college with the students, with the results, with everything. And they wanted themselves now to be enrolled. And definitely I would like to thank for the initiative taken by Ministry of IT and the kind of commitment Madam has in terms of Enhanced Edu program. And we also like to thank to be part of this program and giving us an opportunity to work for research projects and other things also. Whether we are into IT or a project or not, but we are, I give a commitment that we will be there always with Enhanced Edu in terms of implementing CIT and STEP program. I have seen the change, I have seen the difference. Definitely I feel that it should be completely implemented in each and every branch. In fact, I am trying to think of implementing for civil and mechanical branches, but as of now, because of the limitations in terms of laboratory usage and other things, I was not able to go ahead. But definitely I'll see that that will also be included. Thank you once again.